Hello, welcome students, good afternoon. Here Sonu sir with a new video of class 8 SST. And in that we are taking civics portion today. And we were on chapter 2 and there were last topics which were left of chapter 2, that is the parliamentary system of government. And in that students we were on last topic and that was making of laws. कानून का निर्माण या कानून बनाना, तो द लॉ मेकिंग प्रोसेस इज बीइंग डन इन लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा एंड बोथ हाउसेस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट, सेंट्रल पार्लियामेंट. एंड स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट पावर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट एंड इन दैट we have been discussed so many topics like legislative power, powers to control the executive, financial powers, judicial powers, powers to amend the constitution. So these were powers of parliamentary system and parliament. Now what is the work of parliamentary system and parliament? And the major work of parliament is to make laws, to make policies, to make acts, you know. The laws are made in the parliament. The process of framing of law includes the introduction of a bill in the parliament. There are two main types of bills, ordinary bill and money bill. So students, if any law has to made up in parliament, Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, so first that law will be taken in parliament as bill, in the form of bill. All the laws which are going to be passed in parliament, either house of parliament, either is, you know, Lok Sabha and either is Rajya Sabha. So in both the act and laws, the policies which are have to frame is introduced in the form of a bill, in the form of a draft, you can say a draft or bill. And the, you know, documented. What is bill? Documents, written documents of that, you know, individual law which is going to frame, which is going to change or amend. So all the law making process is being done in parliament, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and that laws and policies which are going to frame, which are going to constitute in parliament, has to be firstly introduced in a form, as a form of a bill, as a form of a written document, as a form of a, you know, draft which is proposed, which is supposed about the, you know, bill and about the concept of that law which is going to frame it. So students, all the law which is going to discuss or frame in either houses of parliament are taken as a form of a bill, as a form of a written document, as a form of a written draft. And on that particular issues which are written in that bill and draft are going to be discussed in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and after the healthy discussion, the conclusion will come out there, and by that we can say that this bill is passed in Lok Sabha, and after passing that bill in Lok Sabha have to be passed in Rajya Sabha, and after both the houses president has to sign on that bill, and after then that bill will become act or law or policy and rule. So students, इन दैट प्रोसेस व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू मेक अ लॉ, जब हम कोई कानून बनाने जा रहे हैं, वी आर गोइंग टू मेक अ लॉ, तो दैट टाइम वी आर टेकिंग दैट लॉ, दैट रूल एज अ रिटन डॉक्यूमेंट, एज अ ड्राफ्ट, एज अ बिल, एंड आफ्टर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दैट बिल द डिस्कशन स्टार्टेड इन लोकसभा एंड देन द प्रोसेस इज देयर. सो इन दैट देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ बिल. First is ordinary bill, साधारण bill. Then second is money bill, आर्थिक bill. So students, if there is a discussion on a money bill, that is budget. There is a budget is going to announce or announced for next session. So for that, firstly, the draft of the demanding budget is going to introduce in Lok Sabha. And first, you have to know money bill can only introduced in Lok Sabha, not in Rajya Sabha. So this is important. Although it can be introduced in both the houses, but money bill only can be introduced in the Lok Sabha, because the executive power is in Lok Sabha with Prime Minister and his council of or her council of ministers. So they decide and they mainly discussed about the money bill, and they mainly introduce the money bill, and the financial minister of government, which is under Prime Minister, introduces the bill, money bill, in the Lok Sabha. So there are two types of main bill, and that is ordinary bill and money bill. And if we talk about these two bills, so first our topic is ordinary bill. And ordinary bill becomes a law after undergoing various stages. So if a bill is a public issue of any kind of except money bill, so it has to be undergo with various stages, and that are first reading. The first stage is first reading. The introduction of a bill is known as the first reading. So when we introduce a bill, that is ordinary bill, in Lok Sabha, so then it becomes, then we say this introduction of bill, first reading. This process is known as first reading. And ordinary bill can be introduced in either house of the parliament. So except money bill, all types of bill can be like that introduced. And ordinary bill can be introduced in Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha, in both the houses. But money bill can be introduced in Lok Sabha only. So this ordinary bill can be introduced in Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. And the minister who introduces a bill explains its objects and relevance. So the minister who introduces the bill explains the relevance, the importance of that bill, and objectives, what is the aim and target of that bill, what is the objective of that bill is introduced by that minister. And any minister can introduce bill from Council of Ministers, and this introduction of ordinary bill is known as first reading. Then student, there is our next process. While we introduce ordinary bill in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, second reading. First reading is there, then there is second reading. In this reading, close by close discussion of a bill takes place. Advantages and disadvantages of a bill are highlighted. It is followed by a voting session in which the members vote in favor or against the bill. So in first reading, the introduction of bill is there. In second reading, there is discussion on that bill, the merits and demerits of that bill, the advantages and disadvantages of the bill is highlighted in discussion, and it is followed by a voting process, and in that major vote and 2/3 vote is accepted as the winning vote. So students, that we have been discussed in previous video. So after voting on a bill, some members would be against of that bill, some members would be in favor of that bill. If the number and the countings of favor member is more, so then that bill will be passed. There is third reading, student. In this stage, minor changes are done. So after discussion, some minor changes has been done. have been done. The bill is passed by a simple majority and passes from one house to the other. So after getting 2/3 vote, the bill can be passed with simple majority. And then to check that bill, it goes to the Rajya Sabha. So students, after passing a bill in Lok Sabha, it will be introduced in Rajya Sabha, and the process which is already done in Lok Sabha will also repeated in Rajya Sabha. That 2/3 member of there also have to be in favor of that bill, then only that bill will be passed from Rajya Sabha, then it will go for sign to the president. Then students, we see that the bill passes through similar stages in the other house as well. After the bill is passed in both the houses, it goes to the president for his her approval. Then we see president's assent. A bill becomes a law only if it receives the assent of the president. That means, what is assent? A-S-A-S-S-E-N-T, that is Sahamati. Sahamati. After the assent and after the allowance of president, the bill is passed. The president can withhold his her assent and return the bill to the house for reconsideration. And there is power of the president that he or she can hold that bill by his or her assent and can send and send back that bill for reconsideration, for recheck. And if the bill is passed with or without the amendments after such reconsideration, the president approves the bill and it becomes a law. So after reconsideration, it may be possible that there would not any change going to happen. But it can be happened that some changes can be happened and. Can be happened because if there is reconsideration after reback of president assent, so then reconsideration and rediscussion of that bill can be occurred, and if the as it is bill passed another time, so president has to sign on that. Then our last topic is students, money bill. A money bill passes through the same stages as that one of an ordinary bill. So like ordinary bill, money bill is also going through the same stages, but we have to know money bill only can be introduced in Lok Sabha. So it differs from an ordinary bill in the following ways. How it differs from ordinary bill? A money bill can only be introduced only in Lok Sabha. Once a money bill is sent to Rajya Sabha, it has to be returned within 4 days. Rajya Sabha can suggest only minor changes. So Rajya Sabha cannot change the bill which is passed in Lok Sabha, but they only do some minor changes, and they can hold the bill, money bill in Rajya Sabha only for 14 days, and the lower house may or may not accept the changes before sending it to the president for his her assent. So the changes which is considered by Rajya Sabha, it is depend on lower house, that is Lok Sabha, that the changes would be accepted or not by lower house, by Lok Sabha. So Rajya Sabha is not having any kind of power in money bill. They can only give some suggestions. They can take that bill only for 14 days, and if those suggestions are not required or not followable, so lower house, that means Lok Sabha, can reject those suggestions and can pass the bill which they wanted. So students, so the passing of money bill is power of Lok Sabha, and the president cannot withhold the money bill, and president also cannot withhold the money bill. So Rajya Sabha is also having limited power for a money bill, and president also having limited power for a money bill. Lok Sabha and Prime Minister, that leader of Lok Sabha, and the Council of Ministers and they are responsible for money bill, and money bill always have been introduced by financial minister, and this bill is only introduced in Lok Sabha, and money bill can be passed by Lok Sabha only. Raj Sabha can give some suggestions, some minor changes can they can done, but if they, that changes are accepted to Lok Sabha, if that changes are not accepted to Lok Sabha, that changes will be deleted. And President is also bound to sign on the bill of money bill if it is passed in Lok Sabha. Then students, we see the President cannot withdraw the money bill. A minister can introduce the money bill in the Parliament only with the prior permission of the President of India. So money bill can be introduced by the permission of President, this is clear. And prior permission, that means President is bound to give permission, and that is why it is called prior permission. So after the permission of President, and this is prior permission, money bill can be introduced in Lok Sabha. And I get to know, we see Ganesh Vasudev Mavlankar was the first speaker of the Lok Sabha. This is word of general knowledge that Ganesh Vasudev Mavlankar was the first speaker of the Lok Sabha. Okay, students, in summary, we see India has a parliamentary system of government. This type of government enables the citizens to participate in the decision making process of the country. So public opinion is there, so parliamentary system is enables the citizens to participate in decision making process, because we give votes, we elect our Prime Minister, Chief Minister and Executive Powers and Council of Ministers. The Indian Parliament has two houses, Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. Parliament is the union legislature of our country. It consists of the President, Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. In India, the head of the state is President, while the head of government is the Prime Minister. There are two main types of bill, ordinary and money bills. An ordinary bill can be introduced in either house of the Parliament, but a money bill can only be introduced in the Lok Sabha. So students, today we completed this lesson. In next video, we will read further lesson 3, chapter 3. In this today's homework, you have to do I think and I reflect, I discover, I link, I extend, I observe, and I learn more. These all things are important. And if there is any query or question, you can ask for my number. Students, till then, have a nice day. Thank you.